I have been using the Azure Kubernetes Service or AKS for past few years. Recently, Microsoft announced preview availability of the Mariner AKS container host. Mariner is quite special. It's a custom distribution or open source distribution of Linux created by Microsoft specifically for cloud environment. In this blog post, we can see what Microsoft announced as part of this preview availability. And internally, Microsoft teams or engineering teams have been using Mariner in production for various services like Xbox, PlayFab, Minecraft, and 100 plus other Azure services. Some of the benefits of using this is it is optimized to run in Azure. It contains very minimal set of packages. It doesn't contain any UI packages and things which are not required to run the Linux in cloud environments, which makes it quite secure because it reduces the surface for the attack. It's also lean. The image is very small and it is targeted for deployment in edge environments and in low constrained resource environments. And you can go through this blog to understand what are the other benefits. I won't bore you by giving all those details. Now, why do we need to use Mariner? That's a kind of question which comes to my mind. When I start using AKS, there are various things that AKS offers as a managed Kubernetes offering from Microsoft, and I've been using various enhancements that have happened over the years, and I thought of giving this a try. So first thing why we want to use Mariner is it is a native AKS image that is provided, and it is built from scratch. It is very lightweight and it contains only the set of necessary packages that are needed to run the container workloads. And we can see that in the documentation, it also says that it's an open source Linux distribution created by Microsoft. It supports the consistency and reliability for different kinds of workloads like cloud to edge across the AKS, AKS HCI, and the ARC products. So let's see how we can use this for our project. I've been using a project which is like a producer and consumer. It's been my bread and butter on AKS for years. I've run it through various versions of AKS. I've made various upgrades to the code itself, and I feel very comfortable using that on any version of AKS. So let's see if I can deploy this particular version of my project onto this AKS cluster, which is created using the Mariner OS. So my name is Nilesh, and in this video, we are going to see how to create an AKS cluster with Mariner OS and then deploy the application on top of that. There are some prerequisites which are required to be fulfilled before we can get started. Let's switch to the terminal and look at some of these prerequisites. The first thing is we need Azure CLI. One of the limitations right now with the Mariner OS or the preview is this can be deployed only with Azure CLI, or it can be deployed with Azure Resource Manager or ARM template. We cannot deploy it from the Azure portal or using things like Terraform. So I'm going to use Azure CLI, and we need to have the latest version of Azure CLI. We can see that I have the latest version. If I run the AZ version command on the terminal, I'm running on 2.42.0 version of Azure CLI. And it also requires a preview version or an extension called AKS Preview. The minimum version of AKS Preview, which is required, is 0.5.95. And currently I have 0.5.115, which is much higher than the minimum required version. If you don't have Azure CLI, you can install Azure CLI and you can also install the AKS Preview. Now, if you don't have AKS Preview, you can run this command, which is AZ and then the extension to enable these extensions, and we can use the command which is the add AKS preview or add --name and the name of the version or name of the extension, which is AKS preview. If you already have it, you can update it using this AZ extension update name and AKS preview command. If you want to be safe, you can also remove it using the AZ extension remove command and then re-add it just to be safe. Since I already have it, I'm going to go ahead and create this AKS cluster using a script, PowerShell script. I've been using this PowerShell script, which is like a one-click deployment for my application. It creates various things like starting with the initialization of the AKS cluster, or it creates the cluster in the first place. Then it goes and deploys RabbitMQ cluster using Helm charts onto the AKS. It also deploys other dependencies for my application like KEDA, which is Kubernetes-based event-driven auto-scaling project or product. And then it deploys my application. And finally, it also deploys auto-scale cluster or cluster auto-scaler or KEDA auto-scaler, sorry. So all these things are done as part of this script. But the most important part that we are going to focus is the creation of AKS cluster. I have this script created with various parameters like the resource group name, the location of the resource group where it needs to be created, the Kubernetes version that I want to use. I will be using 1.24.6 version of Kubernetes on this cluster, and also the private container registry, which is named as NGACR registry, where my Docker images or container images are stored. So in terms of creating the AKS cluster, we use the az aks create command and pass these different command line flags or inputs. The thing to note when it comes to creating the Mariner based AKS cluster is the last two things. One, which is the OS SKU, and we specify Mariner as the SKU. The second thing is the node OS disk type. We are going to use ephemeral disk type. Now, ephemeral disks is again a type of disk or a feature which is enabled for AKS cluster. If you don't use the ephemeral disk, by default, Azure will automatically replicate the operating system disk to a virtual machine or for a virtual machine to Azure storage to avoid any data loss if the VM is to be relocated to another host in case of any unforeseen event. But when it comes to containers are supposed to be ephemeral. They don't store any local state. And if we are not going to store any local state on the disk, we don't really need a local disk. In that case, we can create a virtual machine, the underlying VM, which will be used to run the Kubernetes as a ephemeral OS. This is again a sort of performance enhancement or optimization that we can use while creating the AKS cluster with Mariner OS. With this, we can go ahead and create the cluster. I have already ran this script in the interest of time because it takes some time to provision the AKS cluster, and I'll show you the output of that PowerShell script. Here we can see that it has created the cluster, and in the details that we get once the cluster is created, we can see that it has used the OS SKU as Mariner, OS type is Linux, and also the OS disk type is ephemeral. Once this is done, once the cluster is created, we get the credentials to the cluster and we deploy all the other dependencies for the application, and the application containers are also deployed. If I run the kubectl get pods, we can see that RabbitMQ is running, there is the producer is running, and I also have the consumer, which is scaled based on the events. So to test this, I'm going to use Postman and generate a set of workload. So if I use Lens, which is one of the visualizer for visualizing the state of the Kubernetes cluster, we can see under the pods, the same three sets of pods which we saw on the terminal output. And then under the services, we have the RabbitMQ producer service created. And I have the external IP exposing this service to the outside world. I'm going to use this external IP and generate a workload. I'm going to generate 10,000 messages onto RabbitMQ, and if everything is fine, which we know that we get the status as 200, which means 10,000 messages were generated. In the pods, I'm expecting the number of consumers to increase, which is currently zero. But since we have 10,000 messages to be processed, there will be a set of pods which will be created of the type of RabbitMQ consumer. And we can see here that the consumers are coming up. There are progressively, there will be more number of consumers added. Now in this consumer, I can verify that it's running fine by going into the logs, and every 2 seconds I can find a message saying a particular message was picked up by the consumer and it was processed, which means that everything is working fine. So that tells us that With these changes, using the ephemeral disk and the type as Mariner OS, I am able to deploy a Kubernetes cluster, AKS cluster. We can also verify this by going into the portal. I'm looking at the node pool details for my Azure Singapore cluster, which was created. And in the details of the node pool, we can see here the OS disk type is shown as ephemeral, and also the node image, which is used for the OS, is AKS CBL Mariner V-Gen 2 and 10.17 version. Now, with this, we know that our application is working fine. Can I use Mariner as my target OS or operating system for all the Kubernetes cluster that I provision? Since this is in preview, I wouldn't recommend doing that because there are some limitations of using the Mariner as the operating system. Here are the list of the limitations which are currently related to the Mariner OS. It does not support all the SKU types. We cannot run GPU workloads, or it cannot run on ARM64 based SGX or FIPS kind of environment. If you need to run this kind of workloads, currently Mariner is not a good choice. It does not also have the FedRAMP, FIPS and CIS certification. We cannot deploy it through the portal or using infrastructure as code tooling like Terraform. Only the Azure CLI and the ARM templates can be used. When it comes to vulnerability scanning tools, Qualys and Trivy are the only ones which are currently supported. We are also limited to the number of host images or the types. The Gen 2 image is the only one which is supported. Gen 1 SKUs are not supported. It can also be used, or it does not have support for GitHub Actions. So CI/CD, if you are going to deploy, this is a limitation. And there are various other things, including like the extensions, add-ons, and open source integrations. Not all are supported on Mariner as of now. So far, Azure Monitor, Grafana, Helm, Key Vault, and Container Insights are confirmed to be supported. And Azure Diagnostic does not support yet the Mariner. So to run a production workload, you might require some of these features, and hence it is not recommended to use Mariner-based AKS cluster in production while it is in preview. I do hope that by the time it goes GA, we will see a lot of these enhancements added into the feature set, and it would be more production ready. So with that, we come to the end of this session, but I would like to also highlight that there are various other resources which are available on this channel which are related to AKS. I've done sessions on how to integrate Azure Active Directory with AKS. I've also done things around how to integrate a private container registry like Azure Container Registry or ACR with AKS cluster. If you're looking at serverless, I've done multiple public sessions, as well as there is a video on the channel where we can run workloads on serverless Azure container instances using virtual node. So I hope you find these resources useful on top of just creating a AKS cluster. Thanks for watching this video. Until next time, code with passion and strive for excellence.